Crunch. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Breakfast Stream. And also Thursday. Do you know there's a hype train happening?
What?
Okay.
We didn't have it up. We had the other
screen up. We had the timer up. Oh. Well then. A hearty hi P to all of you. When I say it like a hearty, it sounds like it's like Irish or something. Hearty. Actually, that just sounds kind of like a pirate thing. Can I help you?
I thought that's how Kepi, but it was your arm.
So, good morning. Folks are milk bombing and all sorts of things. Level 2 on the hype train is already complete, and you're most of the way through level 3. Gracious. If you're new, it's possible. If you're new here and you're not sure how the hype train works, once the train's been started, if you join the train by cheering, I think at least 100 bits, then when the train is over, you get a special
coffee.
You get a special coffee. Twitch mails you coffee. They don't do that. Then you get a special emote. Which is really neat. So consider getting on board, and level 3 is done. Good God. Alright, let me read some of this stuff. As Renee says, 100-bit subbing or gift subbing. Well, all of those things will put you in the spot to receive a...
coffee.
Emote.
How did that happen twice? How? How on earth could that happen twice? What are the odds?
Coffee.
What a strange morning already. Good Lord. So I'm going to read some of these. You will not receive coffee. You have to get your own coffee. Gracious.
Well, look at the ones Renee has. You okay?
Oh my God, yeah. It's just funny. Because, like, sure, that can happen once. But the fact for it to happen back to back... exactly where I'm saying it within the span of like 30 seconds is absurd. I got subs this morning from Metal Rock Ninja and Yiling Wang 89. Thank you both. 18 month resub from Satsy. It's One Plus. Do you remember blueberry Pop Tarts? Do you remember blueberry coffee? Or can you still get those in the States? I kind of miss those. Never had those.
I think you can still get them, but. Certain stores have a better variety of different things, like...
blueberries in my Pop-Tarts, but maybe not in the States.
Look, I've noticed that Publix has a bigger variety of things when we go there.
Depends on what it is.
Yeah, it does.
Depends on what it
is. Because, like, they had a million different granola bars the other day. And, like, there's not enough... granola bars at Walmart. Like, they just have, like, a couple of each flavor. But Walmart has all the Pop-Tarts, and Publix does not have that many Pop-Tarts.
It's true. It's true. But I've never had a blueberry Pop-Tart. I've had, like... growing up, I ate the cinnamon sugar ones.
Exclusively?
Relatively exclusively. But I also like to get the chocolate fudge ones. And, freeze them.
If you ate those warm, though, they tasted like brownies.
I would eat them warm occasionally, too. But I like to freeze them. They're good. 13-month resub from Kate Carbon.
Coffee!
When you record your vlogs, does anyone get annoyed by it, or is everyone used to it? I know if I recorded my family, they would probably punch the camera out of my hand. At this point, most everyone knows what I'm doing. And then also, I try to always be careful about what I'm doing and what I'm filming as well. So, like...
you also have a history of...
having
not just doing it, but, like... I'm so, like, when we record our friends, like, when we're...
Is she still spinning?
Is she still... she is.
She's still in Katamari mode! Jazz programmed her to be a Katamari.
Coffee!
Anyway, what you were saying.
Like... I'm just thinking of, like, times we've been with our friends where we've been drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're always still very trying to show us in the best light.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's...
You have that history, too.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a drama channel. I'm not like, oh, man, this person's gonna said something stupid, now I can abuse it. And I'm like, oh, my God, no, I'm the complete opposite. So, I'm always considering that, and because I have a shelf drama, because I have a history of that, my friends know that I have their best interests in mind. I think it's okay. Like, people know that I'm not going to film something that they don't want filmed. And then also, you know, I feel like everyone that I'm around is comfortable enough that they could just tell me, just don't. So, that's basically how it's worked. And I've said it before, and it's like a joke, but also true, that, you know, if someone doesn't like being filmed, that we'll probably hang out with them less. And, like, that's a joke, but then also not actually a joke, because that's what we do, is we, you know, we film stuff, so.
Did you see what Thomas just said?
No, but I want to. You cut my Miss Pac-Man drinking game very well, and I looked cool, calm, and collected. Well, that's my goal. That's what I try to do. So thank you, Thomas. I'm always trying to make folks, you know, present them in the best light. Holy crap. You guys completed level 3 of the hype train. So you are getting emotes now. The little red monster ones. If you already have those, if you have the full set, then you'll get one from a lower tier. So, I think the emotes are broken. Cool. Good job, Twitch. Well, it might just take a while. Twitch prompted users to use the emotes before they had them. That's possible. Give it like 5 to 10 minutes, probably, before they start working. I have a similar issue when I upload new emotes. Whenever I do it, like, sometimes they'll start working in one place and not another. Twitch hasn't had their coffee yet. I mean, could be it. We got a 16-month resub from Wizard Grad Student. Oh, dang, I'm finally licensed to drive. Also, dang, it does not feel like that long. Yeah, time's passing very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very quickly. Now that we've hit 18 months, it's just a matter of time before we get to 24. And then we'll start seeing some twos in the chat. And I'm excited for that, but also, holy crap, 2 years. Padawan Becca gives a sub to Pasta Dancer 22. Thank you, Becca. ComCody 20 hits 17 months. It's almost that time again. Looks like in 1 month we'll have our second Twitch baby. I'm excited. I hope you give them a good name.
Back-to-back Twitch babies.
But for real, keep up the amazing work that I've enjoyed so much for these past 8 years. Love you both. Thank you, Cody. We're doing our best. We're doing our best. 11 months from Wisenrow. 11! No idea what to actually put here, so confetti and hugs for all. Heart. Love you guys. Thank you. 17 months resub from Missing No Leader. Thank you, Missing No. Sparkstrike gifted a sub to Sassy Soviet. Appreciate that, Sparkstrike. 8 months from Flash the Firefox. 8 amazing months of being subscribed to this channel. Super happy and grateful to be a part of the community. Glad you're here. I hope everyone's having a pretty good Thursday so far. I hope you got a good sleep. Or I hope you're having a good breakfast. I hope something happens to make your Thursday start off pretty good.
Because, like, coffee
might be it. And coffee seems to be interjecting itself into our lives heavily.
Yeah.
But, yeah, you know, the world is a different place today than it was a few months ago, even than it was yesterday. And I hope that there's something that makes your Thursday seem just a little bit better. That is my hope for you. We got a 7-month resub from Byrio Su. Hope I pronounced that right. Ange Min 85 gives 5 subs to George GW94, Juicy Burv, Creditti, Rain On Them, and Frosty Freeze. Ange, thank you. Appreciate that. 300 bits from Dark Sky Destiny. Those bits from last week worked. I got the job.
Yay, congratulations.
There's been so many positive vibes lately around all of this. This was just great. We got people talking about internships and job interviews, and a lot of good stuff's been happening. So congratulations. That is awesome. That is awesome. I'm glad that you got the job. And as a reminder, if anyone is doing like a job interview or any of that stuff, be sure to announce it during breakfast stream so you get all the positive vibes from the entire community. There's a good track record of it. It's working out pretty well. 300 bits from DannyX6. When your roommate is loudly playing music in the shower at 6:45 a.m., it's best to complain about it on the internet. I already asked him to turn it down once. What you gotta do is you gotta, however he's playing it, you gotta connect to it, and you gotta change the music.
Like wirelessly?
Yeah. Like if he's streaming stuff on like Spotify, then you can use his laptop and change it, and it'll come out the phone. So you gotta have like big galaxy brain about how to do that, figure that out, and then find like the worst possible song. Because if they're in the shower, they can't stop it. I'm just saying.
This song.
I mean, this would be good too. Thomas here, don't invade privacy, just ask. And I'm over here like, go onto their laptop, log into their Spotify. I'm just saying, if you've asked someone to turn the music down.
Brandon says, choose It's Raining Men, perfect for the shower.
Thomas is trying to be the voice of reason. I'm over here like, what about just a little bit of chaos? 15 months from Omega Cyborg. Thank you, Omega. 10 months from M.O. Finney. Hi, George family. Glad to catch a stream again. I recently got into Magic.
Sorry, just swallowing coffee wrong.
Yeah, remember it goes in the one where you...
Don't die.
Where you drink, uh-huh. Not the breathe tube. I recently got into Magic the Gathering, and the last of my cards arrived this morning. It's a green deck themed around reptiles. Hope you all have a fantastic day. Well, I'm glad you're getting into Magic. Magic's great. I haven't played in a bit.
Last time I played was with Chaz. When we all had,
Commander decks?
Yeah.
That was a little bit ago. Just like a tiny bit. I'm not sure when. some time ago. One of my goals at some point is to try and regularly play Arena. If I can get to the point where I have enough things in my life balanced where I could stream Arena a little bit, that'd be great. Because I really like Magic and I miss it. But also, it's great. So if you're watching and you're like, oh, I'm really interested in trying it, Arena is actually a good place to get started too.
Chaz just got in chat. And I saw that Brandon asked him how Sumo was. And Thomas is right, Brandon, Chaz is winning by a lot. Chaz has had 2 days with all of his wrestlers win.
For those who are not aware, a lot of people in our group do Fantasy Sumo.
This is our second time doing it.
So everyone's watching Sumo and writing down.
And we all picked 5 people, and if they win, we get 2 points. And yeah, out of all the 5 days so far, Chaz has lost 2 matches.
I'm not in it.
Chaz is totally winning.
But Chaz and Jeff and Thomas and Lindsay and Mao.
23-2, oh my gosh.
23-2 is insane. Good God. Fantasy Sumo is a thing? Sounds better than fantasy football. I mean, there's a lot of people that are just not big sports folks. I'm one of them. I can watch sports, but it's just not my thing. And Sumo is far more interesting to me to watch. So, yeah, start a Fantasy Sumo League with your friends. you might like it.
Someone said Thomas is salty. What does Thomas have? Thomas is beating me. Thomas, you're in second. Chaz has 40 points. Thomas has 26. I have 24. And
oh my god.
Jeff and Lindsay have 20.
The disparity between first and second. Yeah. Oh wow. 40 and then 26.
Yeah.
That's a drop.
Yeah.
Good luck, everybody. Queensteve gifts a sub to Rube Flower. Thank you, Queensteve. SparksRay13 dropping massive milk bomb this morning. 20 subs. Let me tell you where they went. Earth and Tiger, Viscucci. Oh, Snapple, it's Apple. Cyndaquil and Dunsparce, Kokugan, Tropic of You, GhostKid825, Flaming Bagel for Christ, Keith the Yin Yang Werewolf, DragonGirl2571, Cutie Lucy, Shonen Jump 247, Lone Wolf Rider 65, Antisocial Butterfly, Dead End Gaming, Luna Eclipse 547, Regonad222, Celtic Thunderhead, Mr. One Up, and Kirlin Magic. And Coffee. SparkStrike gives a sub to Coffee, conceptually. SparkStrike, thank you. Sincerely appreciate that this morning. So much milk. Making sure that everyone gets their calcium. Randy B, 213 with 100 bits. Randy, thank you. 300 bits from the Ether is real. Choo-choo, bucko. Yeah, the hype train was an interesting thing to come upstairs to because I didn't have it pulled up because we were looking at the timer. Then we pull up chat and we're like, oh, that's happening. But I thank you all for the support. Appreciate it. Murmur with the milk bomb. Five gift subs to Bowser Plush, Thespis Viridian, Ramium, Magnolias, and JDCom6. Murmur, thank you. And then a milk bomb from Jaminsvin. Jaminsvin? I probably get that right. Oh, that's not milk bomb. I'm just bad at reading. That's a. I thought it was five gift subs. It's 5 months. 5 month resub from Good Morning from Jaminsvin, who says, I can eat more toast.
Coffee.
Good,
get that brain working.
Good morning. I haven't watched live in a while, so I'm glad I can catch it today. Have you two ever considered trying to reach fluency in a second language? What language would you choose?
I mean, Japanese would be most useful to me.
If I could choose and I would just know it, I would choose Japanese.
Yeah.
That would be more interesting to me. But if I were to ever try, I would not learn a second language. French, yeah. If I could learn French, then...
I mean, I took 3 years of French. I think that would be cool, too. I've always wanted to learn Polish because my grandfather knew some, and his parents were fluent.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that would be cool. But I learned a few words from someone once, and they're... The ones I learned were not spelled like they were pronounced, and I was so confused.
Wise and Real said, if he could learn French, then all of our fun would go away. So, yeah.
Well, Gamer says, does ASL count? I think so. ASL is really cool.
Mm-hmm. ASL should count. I know the alphabet.
If I could just automatically learn one, like, insert it into my brain, maybe a tonal language would be really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're so difficult. I mean, when we went to China, it was, like, the different ways you say things. Like, I couldn't hear the difference sometimes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I agree. It was...
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi, bud. I mean, asking us to learn that would have been impossible.
Yeah.
So, like, just getting a chance to know that innately would be neat. But again, I would just choose Japanese.
Yeah, that would be most useful to us.
That's the thing that I would...
Hi, darling.
I would care most about, I think. 300 bits from Ange, who says, I always said with my when my husband and I paid off our student loans, I would give out gift subs. Yesterday, we did it.
Congratulations.
That is... a heck of an accomplishment, and you should feel super, super proud. Congratulations.
You're always, so cool.
Always telling people congratulations for, like, jobs and interviews and all that stuff, but, like, paying off student loan debt is great. Congratulations. That is so, so cool. We still have a little ways to go. Don't cry. But we're getting there. We're getting there, but that is awesome. I always love to hear those stories because it's a hole, man. It is a hole, and it is hard to get out of. and you should feel very, very accomplished. Also,
he's so cold. His little beans were cold on me, and his fur was cold.
That's why he came upstairs.
We gotta warm him up.
We get 400 bits from Cobalt Custard. Don't mind me, grandparents, just hopping aboard this here train. No problem, Cobalt. Thank you. I get 180 bits from Satsy, and then 100 bits from Super Nerd Girl 42. Thank you both. 500 bits from Mr. Gameboy 18. Apparently, there's a hype train, though I can't see it on mobile, so hype. Anyway, I played the new Ori game, and I love it, so. I wish I didn't have to work, but I guess listening to my favorite grandparents in 1980X's OST is just as good. Yeah, the new Ori game just came out. Yesterday. I think it was yesterday. And I haven't gotten a chance to try it, but that is certainly in the running for games to be played next month. So, might try that on First 20 next month, depending on all the other games that are going on. But yeah, I think it's been 5 years since the original. So shout out to everyone that's excited about Ori and gets a chance to play it finally. Crunchy Tuna gives a sub to Agent JN007. Thank you, Tuna. Sephiroth 1204 gives a sub to Mike Tizzle 411. Thank you, Sephiroth. Squid with 300 bits. It says, "You get the milk bomb. You get the milk bomb. Everyone gets the milk." Thank you, Squid.
Kepler's staring at you, purring so loud.
Well, his purrs are equal to the amount of beans that I've seen in chat, and you can have the beans. Patreon.com/StephenGeorge or Malmix. Thank you so much to everyone that chooses to support us on those platforms as well. If you're interested, you can go to the website and learn what the perks are and such. And enjoy your beans. And if you're having some liquid beans this morning, enjoy those beans too.
You want tummy pets? Yeah.
Oh, tummy. I heard that as you want the meat pets.
How did you confuse that?
Well, tummy, I basically heard ta as the, so the meat. Because my brain was like, the meat pets?
You want the meat pets.
And I was like, ew, I don't know what that means, but I don't think he does. Tummy pets makes much more sense. Kepler, we have the meat.
Did you warm up?
100 bits from Sonic Fan 00724. Thank you, Sonic.
Renee, meat pets, egg sweats. What is going on at your house?
I'm so glad that
it's Steven.
That meat pets and egg sweats rhymes. It sounds like the beginning of the world's worst country song.
Come here.
Meat pets, down to down. Egg sweats, down to down. 1400 bits from Herald of Exius.
Jess, I hate it. Stop.
I'm going to write it just for Jess. 1400 bits from Herald of Exius. Herald, thank you. No message, but appreciate the support. 100 bits from TrickyNick0920. 300 bits from DannyX6. Not sure if I was on the train before, but definitely on the train now. Did people's emotes start working yet, or is Twitch still in need of coffee? Hopefully things started working. It takes them. It was funny because right after it ended, I saw people posting it, and it was just the text, and I was like, well, it'll get there. Also, Twitch is broken is a thing that's just said often.
Your claws are digging into my arm.
Not working
yet.
Thank
you.
Okay. By the end of the stream, I would hope that they'll probably be working. Probably. 100 bits from Raspberry Kate. Kate, thank you. 6 month resub from Art with Mal. Hype Train! Congrats on Double Plus. 2 months from Lone Wolf 042. Thank you, Wolf. 300 bits from SMX Sonic. Good morning, grandparents. This is my first live breakfast stream. Good morning, and welcome to your first. It's, you know, it's better live. In my opinion. Because remember, if it wasn't live, this interaction would not have happened. Looking for Larry subs. I hope you find him. 300 bits from Akira Dre. Good morning. I hope you have a great day. Thank you, Akira. 250 bits from Philippo 39. Philip, thank you. Yankee Gal 13 gives a sub to Coffee to Last Call. Got to get that coffee before it's gone. Kiri Cat CDXX sends 100 bits. Thank you, Kiri. 2100 bits from Tired Psychopomp 91. Per usual, I just want to hear the awee. Good morning to you both. Good morning, Psychopomp. And I believe that Peggy will be spinning for just one more stream?
Yeah.
Yep. So I hope you enjoyed the spinning Peggy. She'll be spinning tomorrow for the finale of Katamari. And I stand by my claim that we will be finishing the game tomorrow. I know that there has been some doubts whether or not we'll finish it, but we'll finish it. 15 more hours. No. Lance Link says, I see the date on your shirt, but not the text. What does it say? 1962 was a long time ago. Because Taco Bell opened in 1962, and it was a little bit ago. Just a little bit. We got 300 bits from Phantom SVT. Says, good morning, Mal and Steven. First breakfast stream live in a few weeks for me. It's a very busy and weird time for me already, and now our campus has been effectively shut down for the next 3 weeks. Joy that we postdocs and grad students, too, get the campus to ourselves. Silver linings?
Yeah.
Silver linings, I guess? That's kind of what I've been telling myself, you know, over the last 3 weeks as we've been going through our stuff. You know, in the bad, I try and look for the good. So that's my advice to everyone as things start to shut down, because there's going to be lots of stuff that's canceled and shut down. Maybe try and look for the good.
Can't be put his head on my shoulder.
And it might be hard to find, but do the best you can. 1,000 bits from SparkStrike 13. Stop making me want Pop-Tarts. Nothing is open at 6 a.m. You know what? I just finished, like this week, just finished those pretzel Pop-Tarts I bought last month.
Yeah.
And I kind of want more. Not the pretzel ones, but just...
Add them to the list. We're going to the store today because we're out of tortillas.
Hey, Siri. Add Pop-Tarts to our grocery list.
Do you see this cat? He keeps shoving his head against my cheek.
Good cat. Which good boy, Kippy? Yeah, I don't want the pretzel ones again.
Look at this.
He's being very cute. I don't want the pretzel ones again, because, like, they just weren't great, but it's made me want to try Pop-Tarts again, because I haven't had Pop-Tarts in forever, so I'm like, well... I'm at least going to go look.
Just look.
Look. Just going to go look. 13-month resub from Adoodle. Adoodle, thank you.
God, where can I put my head?
Tricky Nick with the Milk Bomb. 5 tier 1 subs. Thank you, Tricky Nick. Still working our way through the alerts, but we're actually making pretty good progress here. 300 bits from Wisenrail. Triple hearts. Appreciate that. Got 100 bits from Leah L. Pritchett. 100 bits from Concept of Van. And 100 bits from King Family 3. Thank you all. Appreciate the support this morning. Sub from Hylian Hero 07. Thank you, Hero. 18-month resub from Maylene, who says, finally having my second Twitch baby. I love it. Congrats on your OnePlus. Although I am grateful that the icons that we use are pluses and not babies.
Yeah.
Like every 9 months, you just get another little baby on the... People get to 27 months, just like a stack of babies. Someone probably somewhere on Twitch is doing that, and they should be stopped. 300 bits from Satsy, who says, Steven streams, a better source of good luck than those chain images you see on Tumblr. I would like to think so. I mean, we've got a pretty good track record going for us, and I'm happy about that, at least. Thank you, Satsy. 13 months from Vinny G Plays. Until Twitch asked me to share, I actually forgot how long I'd been subbed. Feels a lot longer than 13 months, but the whole time you've brought lots of positive vibes and great entertainment to us all, so thank you both very much. No problem. I'm the big goal with doing you know, Tuesday and Thursdays is to, I mean, for one, help people wake up and have motivation to get up, because it's hard. Mornings are hard. But then also, you know, to start the day in as positive a way as you possibly can. So you're alert and you feel just a little bit happier about starting your day. That's the goal, and I think that we've been doing that. So my apologies to everyone about their Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Can't help you there. But two days of the work week, we'll give everyone positive vibes. 7-month resub from Mega Melee Plus. Thank you, Melee. 300 bits from Print 7. So I waited before class today to give my number to a girl I've been watching all year, and I got her number in return. Ah, I really hope this is how I give bits, because I've never done this before, but I had to share the news.
Congratulations.
First, congrats, and yes, you did it right. You did it right. And that's always, it's always such a scary feeling to put yourself out there.
Yeah.
Because you're always worried about things not being reciprocated.
We were talking about that last night.
We were actually.
And how I was glad that you put yourself out there so I didn't have to.
No problem. So yeah, it's a really great feeling whenever it's like, oh! Get to breathe a sigh of relief. 500 bits from Mr. Game Boy 18. I would suggest you don't do a first 20 on the new Ori because major spoilers of first game. Oh, but unless you don't care, then go for it. It is fun. I did not know that. Okay. Noted. Yeah. I would like to play through the original at some point. It's one of the many, many, many games on my potential stream list. With the only thing is that I've heard that it's quite hard. I've heard that Ori and the first Ori game is actually like, it's very beautiful, so it tricks your mind into thinking it's going to be like a little easy, and then you find out it's like super hard. That's the only problem. 300 bits from Daniac6. Speaking of good vibes for jobs, I recently created a new position for myself at work. I created and run the company TikTok account. So far, so good. I love that that's a thing. And like, it is. I mean, there's people that are running different social media accounts for their companies. Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, like, and it's an actual job. It's an actual job position. And it's so weird to think about TikTok being a part of that, but I totally get it, because you have to go where the people are. But that's super cool. So, neat. I mean, have fun with that. That's cool that you you get to run that. We got a sub from Retro Salad LP. Thank you, Retro. Tricky Nick's Milk Bomb went to 5 gift subs. They are Mage's Max, Force Diagram, Zadix Squared, Underneath Tails. That's funny. And Suisho Tomo. Tricky Nick, thank you. 300 bits from Squid, who says, I don't know why, but recently I've been craving apple toaster strudels. I haven't had them in years, and I'd love to try them again.
That's how I feel about raspberry.
Mao talks about toaster strudels all the time. Because if we're talking and I ever bring up Pop-Tarts, she's like, Pop-Tarts are just crappy toaster strudels.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you're not wrong. It's not that they're crappy. It's that toaster strudels have icing on them. You know?
And they're like flaky.
A little bit. Are toaster strudels more expensive than Pop-Tarts? I'm not sure. I haven't bought either of them in forever. It's almost cheating. I mean, do I prefer toaster strudels? Probably. Maybe I should look at toaster strudels. Hey Siri, add toaster strudels to our grocery list.
Okay.
I won't be buying both, but I will be looking at them. I'm interested in pricing them, see what the difference is. What about the toaster strudels with meat in them? Those are new? What? They put meat in them? Actually, to be honest, I would prefer that more.
Hot Pockets?
Yeah, those are just called Hot Pockets. Yeah, mince pie. I've never had one that was branded toaster strudel, but that would be good. I would actually like those more, to be honest, because that would be savory, and I don't really want something sweet in the morning. I would much rather have something savory.
Restaurata says, I think those are they're breakfast strudels. Like, I think they're right.
Well, I'm going to look for those while I'm at the store and just see what that would be like. Because, like, I would prefer that to something sweet. Like, lately, I haven't even been putting jam on my toast because I don't know. I've just not been in the mood for anything sweet in the morning. So I'm having black coffee and just dry toast. And I know that's confused some people because they're like, how could you eat dry toast? And I'm like, I don't know. I don't want anything sweet lately. Just something boring sounds good.
Kepler, you're getting fur everywhere. I can see it in the air.
And that's just what he does. He's good at it.
He's so sweet, though.
Padawan Becca gives a sub to Hella Vanilla. Thank you, Becca. 300 bits from Danny, who says, in response to a previous cheer, a once asked a boy out, not knowing if he was into boys. He wasn't, but he was super chill about it. I mean, that's good.
Yeah.
Because you don't, I guess sometimes you may not know how people are going to react to that, but it's preferable if we get to the point where society is just a little more understanding of that. Thank you, Danny. 215 bits from Hylian Hero 07. Appreciate that. And then Yankee Gal 13 gives a sub to Toaster Strudel 97. When people base their entire online identity around Toaster Strudels.
Okay, Toast Man.
Yeah, but my username is my name. It's not the same. If I was like, I really love toast and put it in my mouth, 0502, that would be different. That'd also be a really long username. I got through the alerts. Except for that one.
And this one.
And that one.
And that one.
Except for those. Yeah, I would, I'd be interested in trying savory toaster strudel. But I'd also be interested in having, like, a toaster strudel again, because, like Squid, it's been years.
It has been years.
It's been so many years. And you said you liked raspberry?
Yeah. Those were the best.
Do they sell them regularly, or is it like a weird...
I saw the Publix.
Okay. Raspberry seems to be, and this is sad because I also love raspberry stuff. Raspberry is definitely a flavor that is, it's always like a specialty thing, you know?
Strawberry is always common. And...
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Like, there's always going to be strawberry. There's always going to be cherry. And then it's like, whatever you're looking for, whether it's jam or toaster strudels or whatever, it feels like raspberry is like a specialty product. And it's harder to get. Raspberry's a dice roll. Yes. Basically that. So, I'm hoping that if they have the toaster strudels and we decide to get them, that they're as good as I remember. Because there's nothing more disappointing than remembering something from your childhood, going out of your way to get it, and then being like, oh... Which, I'm that way a little bit with Cinnamonies from Burger King. Because I had them when I was in high school.
You licked me.
And I had them again. I had them again in college, and I was like, oh, you know, these are not actually very good. It also depended heavily on...
I have to get in my car and get Cinnamonies.
It also depended heavily on the Burger King you went to. Because some of them, you were obsessed with them. I was. Sometimes they were okay, and sometimes they were not okay. But they were never consistently good. And sometimes the ones that were served to you were basically rocks. And you kind of wondered how long they had been there. 16 months from Unbent Reagent. Unbent, thank you. Sassy gives us up to Meat Strudel. Basically what I'm trying to get. Give me one of them, the meat strudels. Moist Crunchy Potato gives a sub to Egg _ Boy. Two underscores. It's just noteworthy because I'm assuming that Egg one underscore boy was taken. And then a 6 month resub from Rara Oaks, who says, okay, hopefully this is the last time I have to do this. I got double plus. Woo! Also, you guys are amazing. All the Steven am about to make your life crazy during Extra Life. Disney Princess for Wii is getting my vote. Which Disney Princess game? I think there's a normal Disney Princess game, but then there's also like a U-Draw.
There's also an Island Princess.
Well, that's a Barbie.
Oh, wait,
game.
That's Barbie.
That's Barbie. Extra Life will be here before we know it. I mean, people are talking about how quickly, you know, 16 and 18 months has gone. We only have a few more months and it'll be time to play Wii games all day. And I'm excited about it. I'm very excited about it.
Chaz says, every princess game in a row, make it happen, chat. But Chaz, I want to play Let's Play Ballerina, and is it Let's Play Lumberjack?
It's called... Is it Let's Play Lumberjack or Let's Go Lumberjack?
Something like
or
that.
Go Play Lumberjack?
Something.
There's a Lumberjack game.
Oh, so this is a backleg? Sorry.
Rarooks, thank you, and congrats on Double Plus. And I look forward to whatever nonsense people make us play. I'm here for it. There's so many Pokemon Go Lumberjack. There are so many ridiculous titles, and even down to like Disney Princess stuff, there's a good bit. But yeah, there's also U-Draw, which we have the tablet for, so just U-Draw games all afternoon.
Hi.
That could be fun. GoldMage162 gives a sub to Burial at Sea. For those who are interested, that'll be back on the channel on the 21st. So if you're looking forward to watching more Bioshock Infinite, 21st. Haven't recorded it yet. That'll probably be early next week. But I'm looking forward to it.
Kippy's
should be a good time.
You.
Light says, really? Really. Absolutely really.
Kippy's looking at you.
Good boy. And Dan is, Dan was very excited for me to play Bioshock Infinite. And he's very excited for me to play the DLC also. Because apparently, all the crazy stuff that happens in Infinite, there's more crazy stuff. So, I'm excited about it. Bioshock Collection was on sale, so I bought it and have you to thank for it. Aw. I'm glad that I could help. It's a great collection of games. All of them are amazing. Even 2. I always have to clarify, because there's some people that are like, eh, but 2. And I'm like, no, 2 is very good. 2 is very, very good. It's different. It's a little different, but it's very, very good. And there's a lot of things that are being delayed right now, and it seems to be that one of them could be the Nintendo Direct. But I'm hoping that we get information soon that the Bioshock Collection is coming to Switch. Because there's so much information that is pointed to it happening, so... Hopefully soon people on the Switch will be able to experience Bioshock as well. Hopefully. Gotta upgrade Snakebag to handle non-Latin script names with Latin alts. GoldMage162 gifted a sub, but I can't read it because it there's no English characters. Maybe on Twitch it shows the English characters, but on this it does not. So I'm just going to say thank you for the guest sub and that I cannot read it. Jess says it was Fishing Princess. Okay. Fishing Princess. Well, Chaz will fix that. Chaz Labs is a work in progress. Goldmage, thank you. GameHunter09 resubscribes for 2 months and says, I've been lurking in the shadows for a while and decided to use my free Amazon Prime sub on you. Happy Thursday. Aw, thank you. I appreciate that. And I hope your Thursday is going good. Only, only another day before the weekend. And again, tomorrow we'll be playing Katamari, so that's a good way to end off the week, too. Especially because, no offense against the first half of Katamari, But the second half of Katamari is better than the first. Because in my opinion, the most fun thing about Katamari is how big the Katamari gets. And in the second half of the game, it gets bigger by a lot. And it's so much fun to get to the point where it's like, buildings! So, it's really exciting. So I'm really looking forward to tomorrow. Because that's it's going to be great. I can't wait for us to shout at each other again. There's going to be so much shouting. You are just really loving this, ain't mm-hmm. you? Yeah. Good boy, Kepi. Good boy. 10-month 3 sub from Bubbling Brook. Ooh, almost a year. Appreciate it, Brooke. 10 months. Excuse me. I got a little bit of a burpy burp. So Mal, how is your painting going?
Good.
Like, you think we're within range?
I don't know. Listen, I got Kepi.
You're just loving that?
I do. It's because he's been hanging out with you.
Don't rush the artist. It's all right, Weisenray. I'll just never eat. Mallory doesn't pick up on the obvious. Instead, she just rubs the cat with her face. Mouse.
Chaz has slightly rushed the artist. I'm working, Chaz.
Mouse painting a lot of one thing.
Yeah.
You know, hundreds.
What was it Brandon said the other day?
Hundreds or thousands of one thing.
Brandon was like, I don't remember exactly. I'd have to go look it up. He might know if he's still here. But I was like, I need Chaz to stand over me and tell me not to do things.
I mean, yeah. Yes. It's going well. I've enjoyed seeing the progress, but, you know, as is typical with most things, with most paintings, once you're in the thick of it, you're like, yeah, this took longer than I thought, but it's all right. You're not doing another pointillism thing. No.
No.
No, but it's, I'm excited for everyone to see it. It's a good piece. It's a very, emotional piece. And I'm excited for it to finish up. You're more than halfway done.
Uh-huh.
So that's good. We're getting there. It's... I can't talk about it. GoldMage162 gives a sub to Bag of Snakes. Which, again, something that Chaz said and I don't know what it means. Python? Is it have something to do with Python? Because that's a language that has a snake? I don't know.
Maybe it's an Earthbound reference.
Chaz says, it does not. Okay, well.
Lame Thomas.
I don't get it. And then Goldmage gives us up to Chaz.
It is, I was right.
Thank you, Goldmage.
Sweet. Oh, my arm was tired. It's an Earthbound reference.
Yeah, Bag of Snakes is an item in
that's
Earthbound.
Why.
Is Bag of Snakes is just the snake, but it never runs out, right? I think that's what the Bag of Snakes does. Because in Earthbound, there's a snake item.
Yeah.
And, like, I think it does some damage and has the chance to... It doesn't paralyze an enemy, but it, like, causes them to not move for a turn or something? I don't know.
It's not an item I used often.
Or ever? Is it poison? Does it poison it? I guess that would make sense, too. Yeah, I don't know. It's so interesting because, like, when you play a game, especially if you're replaying a game a lot, and then doubly so if it's an RPG, you get into the swing of playing a very certain way, and you might replay a game 15 times, and there Sure. You'll get in the swing of playing it a very certain way, and then you'll never try certain items. Because that happens to me all the time. I bet there's items in Earthbound I've never used.
Condiments?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what solves that? A randomizer. Well. Earthbound.app. Play the Earthbound randomizer. It's just... Condiments is a big one, too. Because there's so much to Earthbound, and like, you don't even do it. You don't be like, oh, I got ketchup, now let's go buy some fries and eat fries with the ketchup.
To raise my...
my HP by it, actually, yeah, like it's... It's just funny because if you're not familiar with Earthbound, everything I'm saying just sounds like the ramblings of a crazy person.
Don't worry,
you gotta get to ketchup when they buy a prize. You're like, what's he talking about? Sorry. It's a whole thing. The music doesn't help. Yeah, I know, right? Let me put on London Bridge and tell you about you put the ketchup on the fries.
I knew at least one person, because it says in chat if someone's new watching is here this morning. It's like, what is going on?
It's Earthbound is a very big, complex game with a lot of items. So. But also, like I said, it's not just an Earthbound thing. I think it's especially applicable to RPGs. You know, you might have played whatever. I don't know. What's a good example of another one? Chrono Trigger. Persona. It doesn't matter. You get into a habit of playing a very certain way, and then it's like, oh, I'm going to do my, you know, my yearly run of this game. And you start playing it, and then you might experience like some new dialogue or be reminded of things, and then by the end you're like, oh, I've never used the bag of snakes. That's basically what I'm trying to say. It happens a lot. Oh my god, yes, Spifflet. Pokemon is a great example. Pokemon is perfect because subconsciously you're like, oh, I'm going to use, you know, the one Pokemon I always use. Like, oh, I'm going to use Lapras. So then you get Lapras in. You have to force yourself. You have to force yourself at the beginning of the game and be like, no,
I'm picking a different starter.
I'm going to pick a different starter. Mm-hmm. I'm going to choose types that I never use. Like, I never play the game with a steel type. So I'm going to, you know, I'm going to find a steel type and I'm going to use it. It makes the game more interesting, too, if you're going to have multiple replays. But yeah, Pokemon actually might be the best example of that. Because you've got all of these different ways you can do it. And in subsequent playthroughs of Pokemon, there's been often times where I've used the same Pokemon. Because I'm like, yeah, this is the one I like. It's something everybody's guilty of, I think, to some extent. GoldMage162 gives a sub to Nora the Gamer Girl. GoldMage, thank you. So many milk bombs from Gold Mage this morning too. And I haven't played Pokemon in a bit. Although we are playing Pixelmon.
Yeah.
Where I'm trying to rebuild again the same team that I had when I played the game. I mean, that's not quite the same thing. Because it's just fun to see if I can find the same ones.
Yeah.
Also, fun thing to announce, the next episode of Pixelmon will be out Saturday.
Really? Oh.
You watched it.
Yeah, I did.
We just watched it. This should not be a surprise.
We watched it and then I assumed it came out already.
We didn't watch it on a Saturday. We watched it on like a Tuesday or a Monday or something. But no, it'll be out this Saturday.
We watched it. Hasn't everyone seen it?
Nope. Just us. But what day of the week is it really? It's good. It's long. It's the first episode was like an hour and this one's like 50 minutes or something. But we go to the Nether. And as with the first episode, it's a lot of it's a lot of banter. It is, again, not for kids, because getting everyone together and having them play a game and have them not swear is impossible. It's impossible.
Yeah.
That's why we stopped trying, because we knew we couldn't do it. In the very, very early days of Steven and Friends, we actually had, we asked people not to swear. And if they did, we censored it. And then eventually I was like, this is too much work. They can't do it.
Yep.
But of course, then when we gave them the pass, then they just, then they unleashed. Josh Ray gives a sub to JJedi1. Thank you for that. A little milk bomb there. Appreciate it. Imagine the swear jar mounts now. It's overflowing. Or it's just a really big, it's not a jar. It's like one of those like 50 gallon barrels. And it's pretty full. You can't ask me not to swear, then make me play golf with your friends. Thank you, Chaz. I think that's actually the series that has had the most...
swear words?
The most swear words. I think. Out of everything. I believe that incites the most rage. But that's okay. That's okay. Golfing just makes people very angry.
Yeah.
Very, very angry. And I'm here for it. I'm here for it. We'll see what happens. We also recorded the third episode of Pixelmon to be released at some point in the future. We're not sure when. And that one's good too. That one's good too. Nice little Pokemon episodes. Oh God. Anyway, trying to think if there's any other announcements as we get close to 10 here.
Stream tomorrow.
Yeah, I think that's the big thing.
Pixelmon comes out Saturday.
Yeah. Otherwise, you are working.
Yeah.
I'm gonna make a prediction that your painting will not be out Saturday.
As
much as I would love it to be, I don't think it's gonna be.
Can't take too long at Lunch Bunch then today.
I mean, that we won't, but that's that's not gonna be the issue no matter what. Happy Yoshi asks, "What is Pixelmon?" Pixelmon is a
Minecraft
mod that basically makes Minecraft have all of the Pokemon in it. So it's the world of Minecraft, and all of the same stuff is in it, but there's also Pokemon, inexplicably.
And like, you catch them in
Pokemon
and
gyms and centers
and
things like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's really interesting. It's certainly an interesting experience. And it's, you know, it's good. But also, it's not an official thing, and there's definitely some parts of it that are a little rough around the edges. But it's mostly good. It's mostly good, and it's funny. But the first episode came out a while back, and then the second episode will be out this Saturday. So I think it's funny no matter what, but it's probably doubly enjoyable if you are familiar with Pokemon. But not a requirement, because most of it's just us cracking jokes. Most of it. Anyway, I think that's it. Be sure to tune in tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Eastern. Actually, no. Let's 7 p.m. Eastern.
7?
I'm just giving myself a little extra breathing room. Because there's some people that are very worried that we won't have enough time to finish the game. So we're going to aim for like 7. Maybe like 7:15. But basically, a little before 8. So let's aim for like 7-ish. And like maybe the timer will go up at 7 and the stream will actually start at like 7:15. I don't know. But like we're going to aim just like a little bit earlier. if that's all right with Mods, just so, in case Thomas and Chaz are right, we try and finish on time.
If Chaz is right.
Well, we'll see. Because Thomas brought up the fact last Friday, like, what if you lose? And he's right. If we lose a level, that will be not particularly ideal, but, you know, we'll do our best.
Let's see.
We'll do our best.
Brandon says 8. Emmy says, at me in Discord, I'll be there.
Okay. I think Chaz will be around, no matter what. So I'm sure we'll have some folks there at 7.
Fossex, I should be fine.
But, yeah.
Chaz says, ye.
If we fail a level,
Renee will be there.
Things will,
fall apart quickly.
We won't fail though.
Yeah.
Because we've been doing great. We're a good team.
We're a good team.
As long as we can remember that left means 90 degrees and not spin in circles, we'll be fine. Danny with the 2 gift subs, Milk Bomb to Nintendo 1254 and Xenopus Lavis. Danny! Thank you. And with that, I'm going to wrap it up. I hope all of you have a wonderful Thursday, and breathe. Everything will be fine. Remember to stay calm, wash your hands. That's my personal advice. Have a wonderful Thursday. We will see you tomorrow night at 7 p.m.-ish for the continuation and completion. I swear it'll be the completion of Katamari Damacy Reroll. See you then.